to start, I want to do a little experiment. So close your eyes and think. Think about two characteristics that you want, maybe your partner, your friends, or maybe, why not, your teacher. So, why do you choose them? Why are they so important for you? I thought that my partner should be interesting, funny, and intelligent. Nothing wrong, right? But I really feel like I'm guilty. And I'm guilty because, yes, I want someone to be with me with her or his intelligence. But could I ever talk to them if they don't tolerate me? If they are interesting and intelligent, but they don't want to work out for our relationship, which can be an affair or a friendship? How can I make a relationship which is made for two actually working? I am the only one who's trying. And I mean, it's like riding a bike. If one of the two wheels is missing, the bike is unusable, right? Now, I want to list some qualities which probably you haven't thought of, which are patient, loyalty, kind, being nice, being unafraid of toil, and fairness. I bet that everyone wants this quality in his life, maybe not all for himself or herself, because everyone is different, but I'm sure they are really important in a relationship. You can be in a fair friendship, a work relationship, every type of relationship you can think of. But our society prefers us when we are brilliant, when we are selfless, ambitious, cunning, wise, smart, everything you can think of, but not kind. And this is actually sad, because I know that maybe we should take those qualities for granted, so this is why a person who has those attributes as main characteristics is considered to be nothing special. But I want you to understand that we should celebrate those people who actually listen to whom they can stand, who help everyone, and actually are just there when you need them, or just listen when you're speaking. So those people, I am one of those people, and to summarize me and those people, I want to use the word Hufflepuff. And maybe you've heard of Hufflepuff if you ever read or watched Harry Potter, and probably you now are thinking, oh yes, Hufflepuff are the elves who never wins, they are so boring, I mean, they are so quiet, no one wants to be in their house, they have not cool characters, and all the other things I know you're thinking, like something like this. And from the moment Draco Malfoy snarked that, imagine being in Hufflepuff, I would leave, wouldn't you? It established Hufflepuff to be somewhat of an underdog. But, I mean, I'm really sad for this, and now I want you to tell you something about my childhood, or just my middle school period. So in middle school, my teacher made a little experiment. Everyone had to write his or her name on a piece of paper, and everyone else had to write something positive about that person. So guess what were my positive traits? Actually, we had two positive traits, being kind and being kind and helpful. It was quite sad for me because, yeah, a few years ago, I had quite a bad temper, so I understand now that it wasn't easy to be friends with me, to know me so well. And probably this is why they just wrote that I was kind, but it was never a problem for me to be nice to people. It really brings me joy to see people that is happier just because I've been nice to them. It's beautiful to see. But anyway, I started to ask myself if it was enough, to I have to change something. And obviously, in 4 years, something had changed, because I'm normally a person, but something remained the same. And this year, I actually found an answer, which is that Hufflepuff are so much more. I am so much more. And being like me means getting mad with people who harass my friends. It means just listen people because they need an opinion, even if I can stand them, or just, it's also mean to punch someone because they need to shut up, because they need, they are saying nonsense. Don't worry, I never punch someone, but I did slap someone. I also threw an umbrella to a guy the other day, but this is another story. So coming back to the Hufflepuff, I know that maybe you're not one. So there's nothing wrong if you're a Slytherin, a Gryffindor, or a Ravenclaw. But I think that if you have to think about something that you want to add, why don't you think about some Hufflepuff traits? I mean, we change constantly. No one is pure. I'm not a pure Hufflepuff, as probably you're not a pure Ravenclaw or something else. So, as long as you're changing, why don't you want some other traits in your life, in your partner, in someone else? I want to conclude by saying that you may belong in Hufflepuff. Those pure Hufflepuff are unafraid of toil and patient and full of kindness. And I'm proud of being who I am.